Hey, Tranny Star. It's Courtney filling in for Samantha today. Topic this week, I have to look it up again. Crap. Topic this week was how has the way that you've adapted or changed your body work with daily activities? For example, do you use prosthesis? How does this affect the way that you participate in sports? And so on. Or adapt the uniform to your body? How does the new form affect your performance? So, I have some fun experiences around this one. I don't know if they're all very fun, but they're interesting and anecdotal anyway. So, as some of you know, I was trained as a welder, so that's one of my many things that I do. You definitely want to wear shirts that come all the way up to here. Or at least button your welding jacket all the way up. The first couple of times I was, you know, just doing a quick weld in a tank top and things like that, it came to my attention very quickly that, sparks go down your boobs and it's not fun at all. So you end up dancing around the shop like an idiot, and the neighbors across the street think I'm crazy and things like that. So that's definitely been one thing, you know, sparks going in different places. And also I've kind of always had long hair being in the welding industry, but never quite this long. So it is definitely a matter of making sure that I tie my hair up and usually wear some sort of a cap or a beanie of some sort, something in order to, you know, keep my hair from lighting on fire, which is always really fun to run down the street with your hair on fire. One of the other ones, while we're on the topic of hair, that's really fun is I'm also kind of a mechanic-ish. I don't know if I'm that good of a mechanic, but running over my hair with the creeper, which is really horrible, especially if you run up the line of the hair instead of just like across it, because then you have to, like, your head's all sucked back because you just sucked your hair in. And then you have to roll all the way back down until you manage to untangle yourself. And that also means a caster spinning around on your hair. Ow is all I have to say about that. So I always try to remember to tie my hair up in a bun or something like that so I don't roll over it, which is always really neat. One of the other things is strength overall, really. I notice it the most when I'm in my shop. Like, I'll grab something that I've grabbed a million times and that I just throw over my shoulder or whatever. Now I grab it and I'm like, oh, good lord. So I feel like everything's an anchor these days. So things are a lot heavier now because I've lost, you know, a considerable amount of strength. And my arms aren't nearly as big either. So some uniforms are kind of fun because I still have a lot of my old work shirts just because I just burn them up anyway. Some of them don't button all the way to the top anymore, so I have to wear a t-shirt under them because I've got stuff going on upstairs. What are other things? Other things. Oh, I know a good one. You know, you have to make sure that you have everything properly tucked and put where they're supposed to be, and every once in a while I forget that I'm a lady, and I will just, like, lift my leg up and jump up in the back of my truck, which causes all sorts of mayhem, pretty much no matter what I'm wearing, and the tighter it is that I'm wearing, the uglier the show is after that. So I try not to make big leaps with my legs anymore, at least for another little while. What else? Oh, another good one. Grinders. Using grinders. Again, if you don't have a shirt that's buttoned all the way to the top, like all the grinder dust and sparks and stuff go down your shirt. That one's neat. Also, my skin tears a lot when I'm in the shop. Like, stuff, I used to have pretty leathery hands, and now my hands are really nice and baby soft, which is really nice. But they get screwed up pretty easily. Like, I'll come in from working in the shop and I've got like 8 cuts on my hand. I'm like, where did this come from? And I never used to get cut that easily. So it's definitely the thinning out and softening of my skin has changed a lot too. So I try to wear gloves all the time now. When I'm working, even in the yard, I try to wear gloves. What else? Oh, bike shorts. Bike shorts, I used to wear them all the time. I was never really comfortable in them because, you know, you've got, you know, your business on display in spandex shorts. But there's two things with biking that are an issue for me anyway. One of those things is that, you know, you do have the bike shorts, and it's kind of awkward because you can't really tuck and then sit on your seat because then you're sitting on stuff. And it doesn't feel super comfortable. So you can't really tuck, so then you either have to wear shorts over them or get some of those ones, some of those shorts that have, like, the bike shorts built in, or things like that. And the other problem that I have with biking, and this really kind of bums me out because I used to be a pretty big cyclist, and I'm hoping that by next summer things will be a lot different. So, you know, besides all of the downstairs stuff, there's the makeup, because I'm still getting electrolysis done. I'm getting much, much farther along, and hopefully have, like, just another year to go, maybe, before everything's going and my neck's almost completely done. I just have some stuff here that I gotta take care of, and we should be fairly good to go soon. But, you know, I don't really feel comfortable being seen in public without makeup on, just because I feel like it's a giveaway, and I don't, you know, I like to remove as much doubt as possible when I'm in public. So having makeup on is my comfort zone, so that I feel like I don't have a 5 o'clock shadow in the middle of the day. But that's not very conducive to sweating. And when you ride your bike, or at least when I do, because I'm out of shape, you sweat, and then you end up sweating through your makeup, and then you just look like a hot mess. Or at least I do. I don't know if everybody does, but I do. So it's one of those things where, it's not super comfortable all the time. I mean, I'll do it. But I try not to end up at a destination. Like, I used to do that a lot more, just ride into a couple towns over and have a cup of coffee or go have a beer with a friend or something like that. And I just don't do that as much anymore. I'll ride, and then I'll just ride home so they don't have to see people. So, what else has changed? I think that's about it that I can think of anyway. My balance was off for a while when my chest started to grow, but that went away fairly quickly. I kind of regained my balance, but it was pretty funny. About 2 years ago, I was in San Francisco, and I had just kind of gone through a growth spurt, so I ended up basically tripping my way around San Francisco because I had no balance whatsoever. So there you go. I think that's all of the examples that I can give of kind of what happens with, you know, how your body changes in relation to the things that you do. So, Samantha, I hope you have a wonderful time on vacation. She should be back with you all next week. It's been great to fill in and see y'all. And we'll chat with you soon. Take care. Bye-bye.